20 minutes late. That's 10 suicides for the whole team. 250 push-ups for you.
This ain't the track team, man.
Nor is it the debate team, Mr. Lyle. But you're right. And because you're right, that's 20 suicides for the entire team. And you get the privilege of joining Mr. Battle with 250 push-ups of your own.
What, are you serious?
Yeah.
It's bullshit.
Ding, 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 ding. Good answer, Mr. Battle. Johnny, tell him what he's won. Because you gave such a good answer and you gave the coach attitude, you win the bonus prize of 500 push-ups.
We need you to help us get rid of this woman, Mrs. Quickly.
It will not surprise you to hear that I cannot agree to that, Simon.
Then at least will you promise to let us do whatever we have to do to get rid of her?
Are you prepared to accept the consequences?
Yes.
You promise?
Yes, yes, absolutely, I promise.
Then I will, as you put it, let you do whatever you have to do.
Thank you.
Serge! Well, hold on, now wait a minute, quiet! No one's getting thrown out, okay? We're all still here. I mean, yeah, we've lost friends along the way. Wheezy and Etch and
Bo Peep.
Yeah, even Bo. All good toys who've gone on to new owners. But through every yard sale, every spring cleaning, Andy held on to us. He must care about us or we wouldn't be here. You wait. Andy's gonna tuck us in the attic. It'll be safe and warm.
And we'll all be together.
Exactly.
You can't marry a man you just met. You can if it's true love.
Anna, what do you know about true love?
Well, more than you. All you know is how to shut people out.
You asked for my blessing, but my answer is no. Now, excuse me.
Your Majesty, if I may...
I'd love to do it again with you,
so way I can remove the cadet...
Try it! This cadet is trying to save the bridge.
By recommending a full stop mid-warp during a rescue mission...
It's not a rescue mission, listen to me, it's an attack.
Based on what facts?
That same anomaly, a lightning storm in space that we saw today, also occurred on the day of my birth, before a Romulan ship attacked the USS Kelvin. You know that, sir. I read your dissertation. That ship, which had formidable and advanced weaponry, was never seen or heard from again. The Kelvin attack took place on the edge of Klingon space, and at 2300 hours last night, there was an attack. 47 Klingon warbirds destroyed by Romulans, sir, and it was reported that the Romulans were in one ship, one massive ship.
And you know of this Klingon attack. How?
Sir, I intercepted and translated the message myself. Kirk's report is accurate.
We're warping into a trap, sir. The Romulans waiting for us. I promise you that.
The cadet's logic is sound. And Lieutenant Uhura is unmatched in xenolinguistics. We would be wise to accept her conclusion.
Scan Vulcan space. Check for any transmissions in Romulan.
Sir, I'm not sure I can distinguish...
You're hinting that I was in line for that promotion?
And look how hard you've been working.
What? You're just lying to me?
Lying? No, Nick. Motivating. I mean, look, we're all part of the same team here. Plus, you know, I'm the one who's going to be doing all the extra work.
You know that last month you made me work so late, I missed saying goodbye to my gam-gam?
I'm sorry, what?
My grandmother. I told you that I needed to see her because she was very, very sick. You said if I left early, I'd get fired. And she died before I made it to the hospital.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I had no idea that you called your grandmother gam-gam. Sorry you didn't get to say bye-bye to Cam Cam. Really, I'm sorry. But I needed you to stay here and work late because you were an invaluable member of this operation and I need you in the position that you're currently in.
I'm home! Hey, Kylie.
Hey!
Hey, how are my best girlfriends?
My name's George. This is Katie.
Hello, sweetheart. Welcome to our home. I just want you to know, if you need anything, don't be shy, okay?
There are no rules in this house. I'm not like a regular mom. I'm a cool mom. Right, Regina?
Please stop talking.
Oh, good morning. I want to do something pretty rare for a surgeon. I'm going to ask interns for help. I've got this kid, Katie Bryce. Right now, she's a mystery. She doesn't respond to our meds. Labs are clean, scans are pure, but she's having seizures, grand mal seizures with no visible cause. She's a ticking clock. She's going to die if I don't make a diagnosis, which is where you come in. I can't do it alone. I need your extra minds, extra eyes. I need you to play detective. I need you to find out why Katie is having seizures. I know you're tired, you're busy, you got more work than you could possibly handle. I understand. So I'm going to give you an incentive. Whoever finds the answer rides with me. Katie needs surgery. You get to do what no interns get to do. Scrub in to assist on an advanced procedure. Dr. Bailey's going to hand you Katie's chart. The clock is ticking fast, people. We're going to set case like we have to do it soon.
The Starks are gone as well. Our two terrible fathers saw to that. The remaining members of House Lannister will never back you, not ever. Stannis Baratheon won't back you either. His entire claim to the throne rests on the illegitimacy of yours. That leaves the Tyrells. Not impossible. Not enough.
Lannister, Targaryen, Baratheon, Stark, Tyrell. They're all just spokes on a wheel. This one's on top, then that one's on top, and on it spins, crushing those on the ground.
It's a beautiful dream. Stopping the wheel. You're not the first person who's ever dreamt it.
I'm not going to stop the wheel. I'm going to break the wheel.